also, we reunited the 1996 U.S. Women's Gymnastics team. They're back together for the first time 11 years after winning gold there, and you can see what a moment that was. We all remember, and there they are. They taught me a few moves, and clearly I need some help. Oh, yeah, that's good. Just the first of many party fouls by Amy. They're trying
we,
to
we should point out that you were a gymnast for a lot of
and
your growing up
would
years.
Be the emphasis.
The fact that you can do that is impressive.
With a lot of help, you can see they're holding me up. Like, please don't let go.
Kind of like I do.
Exactly like you do every day. Now to our special series, whatever happened to those people and events that once dominated the headlines? Well, it has been more than a decade since seven American women made Olympic history as the first and only U.S. gymnastics team to bring home the gold. And we decided to catch up with these ladies and reunite them in Atlanta, of course, the city where it all happened.
It's a moment we will never forget, the day these magnificent seven girls made history. They are all grown up now, but not a second has faded from memory.
It's like yesterday. I can close my eyes and remember certain things as vivid as if I had just done them.
Shannon Miller was one of the oldest on the team.
My feet hitting the floor when I landed my dismount and knowing that I set my routine, and it didn't matter about the medals or the score or anything else. It was like, okay, I finally hit the right routine at the right time.
Thanks, Shannon!
Being together again brought back both good memories and bad.
I must say, like, at times I wanted to quit, at times I was thinking it was way too much.
We all know what it took in the gym on the days when the cameras weren't around, the days when we were in the gym by ourselves with our coaches, extra days we had to spend crying, and, you know, our blood, sweat, and tears were put into this Olympic medal.
But the sweat and tears molded them into people who can never settle for second place.
I think to be great at anything, you have to want it for yourself, and I know all of us were extremely self-driven and still are.
Most made gymnastics their career as coaches and motivational speakers for young athletes. But Amy Chow chose a different path. She's on her way to becoming a pediatrician.
I've just kind of made those goals for myself and kind of gone after them one by one.
How often do you think of the 96 Olympics?
Not often, especially I'm in the hospital like 80 hours a week.
And what about Carrie Strug? She became an instant celebrity when she landed the vault on an injured ankle, clinching the gold medal for the team.
It wasn't how I had envisioned my Olympic experience to go, though. It goes to show you your dreams can come true, not exactly how you anticipated, but they do come true.
Strug chose to leave gymnastics behind after the Olympics. She went to college, became a teacher, and now works for the Justice Department. But a decade later, still gets asked the same question.
Yeah, I still get, how's your ankle? It's been 11 years. So I'd like to let everybody know it's fine. I've run a few marathons. I work out all the time. It's healed very well.
This is sure to make you feel old. A few of the girls are starting to have children of their own.
Going from a 70-pound 14-year-old to now, embarking on the journey of motherhood, I've been through so many changes.
You're having your own little girl. I mean, what are your hopes for her?
Well, this little girl is definitely going to do a little bit of gymnastics.
It's a family affair for J.C. Phelps, too. She married gymnast Brett McClure. And this time at the 2004 Greek Games, she cheered him on from the other side of the mat.
I think it's easier being the athlete. It's really hard to sit in the stands and watch, but it was also very exciting.
Having caught up on the girls' lives, I got them to show off and show me some moves, too. In fact, this is the very gym where I trained as a young gymnast over two decades ago.
Okay, let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm a little rusty, but I still walked away with a medal.
Wow, I like the way this feels. Okay, see you guys later.
Bye.
Here in the Georgia Dome, these American heroes inspired a generation of girls to go for the gold.
Do you guys still get recognized?
At the weirdest places.
Yeah.
It's funny, I do, but everyone expects us to walk around in leotards
and ponytails,
like
the white scrunchie.
Overnight, these little kids were thrust into the spotlight.
We're growing up on television, on tour, hitting puberty, and you're like, oh my gosh.
It was an adult trapped in that little body, but in so many other ways, I was this innocent little teenager who didn't know much about life.
time taught them about life, but so did gymnastics.
You know, it's something that you just can't get away from. Once gymnastics is in your blood, it's in there for good.
This is a dream come true for us. You know, we made history here in Atlanta, and we're always going to have that special bond together.
And they were called the Magnificent Seven, obviously, for their gymnastic skill. But these girls are amazing. They're all such high achievers, and they're so successful
it's
and so
neat
nice.
To see. Always makes, does make you feel old to see them all grown up. By the way, nice flips there. But that's something for you to sit on, because that looked like you were having a little problems
there. Oh, my gosh.
On the flips.
How about this?
That'll work, too. No, you were doing well. It was just the landing.
It was on a trampoline, so it didn't hurt that bad.
All right,
thanks
fine.
A lot.
That was just for you. I was just thinking about
you.
Yeah,
so you're thinking about
anyway, tomorrow we're going to...